Hey guys, Bill Competition Cars. We're trying to get a bunch of videos done today, and I'm going to be able to squeeze in the driving video today on this 1989 Beretta GTU 5-speed transmission with 18,000 original miles on it. Very nice original car. We're in South Carolina right now, and it's starting to have its pollen season. So we just had this car detailed to the max. It's been outside for maybe 5 or 10 minutes. It's already got a little bit of pollen on the paint. So if the paint looks like it's got some dust on it, that's just from the pollen. I can't help that. Christian, go down the sides. Look how straight and slick that body is. The wheels are in great shape all the way around. This is tired. But they're not banged up or stained or anything. They look good. It's got tinted windows, which I think look really good on the car. I'm going to leave the tinted windows on there. I like it all blacked out. And in some of the pictures I've got, we'll go back down to the front real quick. In some of the pictures, I've got the headlight covers off. Some people find them tacky, but I tell you what, I think it looks pretty tough with the blacked out headlights. They just pop off. If you don't like them, that's fine. Hop in, Chris, go for a little video. Air is ice cold, and I have to tell you, man, I know you guys up north probably will think I'm crazy for saying it, but I hate this time of year. We're still in, what, February? And it's not 70, it's close, and we got this pollen, which is annoying as hell. It just drives me nuts trying to keep these cars clean. You wash them, and then the next day they're yellow. So anyway, back to the Beretta. Flaws on the car, not many. It's got the typical GM dash. It gets, you can't see it from the outside because the guy's got the windows tinted on the bottom and top, which actually looks pretty sweet from the outside. But if you're sitting in the car, you can see it's kind of, they had those crappy cheap dashes in 1989. I remember the Luminas did that, the Berettas did that, the Corsicas did that, the Lumina or the Chevy MPV vans or APVs, whatever they were called. But what I love about this car, besides the look, is the low miles and this 5-speed and being a GTU. GTUs were only made for 2 years, from what I understand, 88, 89. This car is gonna need a headliner drooping in the back, factory sunroof. But I love the way this car drives. It's really fun to drive. It doesn't have a ton of horsepower, but it just makes it, it's a pretty light, nimble car, and having that 5-speed makes it really fun to drive. Power windows work, power locks work, factory radio works. We don't play the radio during the drives because, of course, I've told you 100 times that we're basically monetized. If you play music in the background, they won't monetize your video. All the gears shift nicely. 18,669 miles. About to turn 18,670 miles. Cruise control, horn works, wipers work. Just a really cool car. I mean, this is just one of those cars that you don't see preserved like this. I mean, most of these cars are driven hard and abused and sent to the crusher. So this is a really unique car. Love the fact that it's a stick shift. And that's what really got me excited about this one. And we're gonna turn around and go through the gears and show you. I mean, it's got decent power. I mean, and it's got a good sound. It's got a really throaty sound. GM did a great job with their V6s to get that sound out of them. Excuse me. Beretta across the windshield. That could have been from the factory. I was selling these cars back then. I worked for a Nissan dealer. I started in late November of 88 and sold new Nissans from 88 through 89. And then early in 19, or late in 89 or early in 90, the owner bought the Chevy dealership with Chevy and Oldsmobile. So we had Nissan, Chevy, and Olds. So I was selling these cars back then. And when the Luminas came out, these Beretta GTs and GTUs and Pace cars came out, and they were really hot cars back in the day, and people really loved them. This one's like impeccable condition inside now. Aside from the dash and the headliner, there's really nothing you'll do to this car. Yeah, I like the fact that the wheels are in great shape. Seats are perfect. Turn around, we'll pull out, I'll step on it a little bit. Turn the air down so you can kind of hear the engine. sounds good. It actually handles good too. No slipping of the clutch, no grinding of the gears. It's super smooth. And again, you know me, I'm gonna put them to the paces. I'm not gonna abuse the car, but I do wanna drive it hard enough to show you guys that the car does what it's supposed to do. I'll go through the gears one more time. Start off in first gear. Sorry, that's a cop right there, so let me, hello officer. Listen to that moan. I mean, it's just so cool. I mean, you don't have to have a lot of power to really enjoy the driving experience. I mean, I think the power was in the, I don't know, it was 130 or 40 or 50 horsepower, but it's fun, man. It's just a cool car. It's a lightweight, nimble, handles good, looks good. It's got that late 80s, early 90s NASCAR look, Dale Earnhardt look to it, even though it's a Beretta, with the body kit and the wing on the back and the aero kit. And those headlight covers and it being all blacked out. It's just a really cool car. So hopefully you guys enjoyed the driving video. Tomorrow we'll do the walk around video in the showroom. We'll get it wiped back down, get all this pollen off of it. So wish me luck with the pollen. I got really bad allergies, so I'm surprised about sneezing right now. I'm a little congested, but that's just the one of the trade-offs to living in the South. So there's that. Anyway, put any questions in the comment section. I'll answer them as quickly as I can. We appreciate you guys, and good luck bidding.